If you're looking to give your winter garden a tropical look, Aralia are evergreen shrubs that can add a little zest to shadier areas. Gardening guru Cisco Morris is here to tell us all about them. Cisco, thank you for being here.
Hey,
as
Jerry.
Always, I can give you a hug since the last
time. Yes, right? Good to see you, man.
These are called Aria, but I think they have a fancier name that I didn't want to pronounce today. What is this?
It's Fatsia japonica.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then
that's a fancy name.
This is the Fatsia japonica that we all grew for years.
Right.
This plant can only take shade. No sun at all, or it burns up.
But that's kind of a perfect plant.
Perfect plant, because so many of us have those big conifers, and they don't have a lot of sun.
Right.
So this is great. And they can get 15 feet tall.
Oh, boy.
I grew these as houseplants when I was a kid in Wisconsin, because you're not going to grow this outside
Wisconsin
for anything,
So where do these originate from, then? I know they don't originate from Wisconsin.
Well, they're from Japan.
Okay. Hence
and,
the name.
Yep, they all come from Japan. And then one day, some guy came out, and out of his fatsia was a leaf that looks like this, a little branch with a leaf like this.
Mm-hmm.
Whoever it was said, you know what, if I take cuttings of this section, I'm going to end up driving a Mercedes-Benz because...
and so what? They must do something with it.
So they took cuttings, rooted this, and now they have a brand new plant called Fatsia spider web.
Okay.
And I took this one off my plant at home just to show you how white these flowers can get, because they just, they get so white you can't believe it. You know what's funny? Somebody gave me one in a 4-inch pot.
Okay.
And it was when they first came out.
And they can grow in a 4-inch pot as big as this thing grows?
Well, yeah, only for a little while in that 4-inch pot.
Right.
And I planted it in my garden. I planted a rose in front of it. I didn't know that they gave me the wrong rose at the nursery. It ended up 20 feet tall. I totally forgot. I even planted this thing behind it. 5 years later, the rose got so big I had to get rid of it. I cut it down. It looked spectacular. No sun at all, no water, no nada, and it was magnificent.
So this is the kind of plant that someone like I can grow this, because I don't have a green thumb at all. I have like two thumbs. It's not, neither one of them are green.
You can definitely grow this. You can grow it in the house, in the shade, or you can grow it outside. But a 15-foot house plant can get you in a lot of trouble with your partner. You got to watch out, you know.
So you said they grow 15 feet and they don't need a lot of water, they don't need a lot of sun. Is there a preferred place that you want to grow them then, since they don't need it?
Well, that's a great question. You know where I plant these? Right in the doorway if it's shady.
Mm-hmm.
So if you've got a little garden nook right by the doorway that's in the shade, you'll have this magnificent plant that people just, wow, what is that, you know? And this spider web really lights up a dark, shady corner in the winter.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a brand new variety. This one, so
they're
starting to hybrid these. This is called camouflage.
Okay.
Some people like this better, but this is still my baby right here, you know. But
what are these little things right
those
here?
Those are the flowers.
Okay.
And now the flowers are gone. They were kind of open white, but not that showy, but they're pretty.
Mm-hmm.
Now these berries will turn dark and the birds will swoop in and just gobble these up. This is like...
So you'll have like a nursery with all kind of animals and stuff in your yard?
Yeah, this is bird pizza right here. Let me tell you what, it's really, they just love these. So also you get, when people are coming to your door, they're gonna see all these cool birds eating the berries. It's just the best plant.
So what about these plants? Like, do they ever, you know, because sometimes, like I said, I don't have a green thumb, and sometimes the plants around my house and in my yard, they start looking a little sad.
Yeah, you know.
So do these ever start looking sad? And if they do, what can you do?
So I brought one with a few ugly spots on it.
Oh, yeah.
So hopefully, yeah, you can see that pretty good right there. And after you've had these in your garden for a long time, you start seeing a lot of those ugly spots. So there's a really good medicine for that. You go out there with your pruners and chop it down within 6 inches of the ground. The whole 15-foot monster, and it'll grow back by the end of summer. It'll be 4 or 5 feet tall and be beautiful. And you won't have to do that again for another 8 or 9 years.
Okay, so if I wanted to take one of these plants and grow one, the 15 to 20-foot type variety that you're talking about, can I do it now in January in Seattle and grow a plant?
Yeah,
just like
you
this?
Betcha. Anything you could find, I borrowed these at Swanson's Nursery, which I appreciate so much. But anything you find at a nursery in a pot like this in the outdoor section, you don't have to worry about them getting too cold. You take them home, you plant them. The key thing for everybody to remember is never plant them any deeper than they came out of the pot.
And why is that?
That
again, talking to somebody that doesn't know.
All right, the roots are used to a certain amount of oxygen down there under the ground, even in a pot. If you plant it even an inch deeper, there's a lot less oxygen down there. The roots start suffocating.
Okay.
Yep, so that's true about almost every plant. Only a tomato you could plant deeper.
I didn't know that. I have a thing that grows my plants upside down, the upside down
topsoil. Oh, you got that upside down
the
tomato
thing? You get
thing?
On TV, like you can only buy it here on TV. I got it there.
Do you get that to work?
No.
Or
no.
Neither do I.
I gave it a shot, though.
I was about to say, you got the greenest thumb anybody I've ever met.
No, I have no green thumb, and I have no green luck. I have none of that. But I am going to try one of these, and I can just go to them in the nursery and grab one and take it home, and I can grow up 15, 20-foot plants.
This is the beginning of a green thumb. I could see it coming right now.
Well, I can tell you what. I've been watching you do your thing for years, and I've been wanting to try, and I've been nervous. But now that I got a chance to talk to you one-on-one, I'm feeling a lot better about my opportunities, especially with the Aurelias. This is a no-brainer plant.
This is
that you don't need to use.
No-brain's really fun, and people, when they come to your house, they're going to go, that is the most spectacular plant I've ever seen. Even gives a tropical flair.
It does. I feel real tropical right now. Right now, Cisco. Thank you for hanging out with me for this time, man. I appreciate you, man. Looking forward to seeing you again. Hey, when we come back, though, are you trying to start a new diet for the new year? Our nutritionist explains that intuitive eating is what you should know all about before going ahead with your next diet. That's coming up next.